when I arrived at a penniless refugee in the United States, it really was penniless because I remember we had $20 and we're sort of robbed only in the literary but figurative way by a cab driver who charges an enormous amount of money, the trip from the ship to the only relative we had at that time in New York, where we spent the first night there. I immediately went to school, and that itself is an amusing story. I said I learned English in American school in Sofia, which was called American College. Of course, college in the United States clearly means first 4 years of university. College in other areas can mean anything from from, you know, a form of high school to a boarding school and so on, and that's what it meant in Sofia. I had just begun my junior year college. I was 16, so I would have, according to the American, or for that matter, European system, needed 2 more years of high school education. One of my American teachers at the American College in Sofia, and I was a very good student during that last year, in contrast to a somewhat mediocre one in Vienna, where I had other priorities, sports and so on, but by the time I was in Sofia, it was clear to me that grades would count a lot, and I really exerted myself and did very well. Said, I'll give you the address of a friend of mine in New York who can advise you where to go to high school, since obviously there would be quite a number of choices in New York, and I knew nothing really about the American educational system. And that man taught at New York University. At that time, to me, he looked like a hair professor. In fact, he was probably nothing but an instructor or a young assistant, untenured assistant professor, but it doesn't make any difference. I called him and asked whether I could make an appointment. It was very nice and said, come. As I said, he was a friend of a teacher of mine in Sofia. And I had my certificate with me, which I carried, and said I want to ask you for advice in about schooling. Now, I arrived in December, so this was very early January, right after Christmas, which of course is the middle of the school year. And he looked at that and he said, you know, unfortunately, we can't take you here because we admit people only in the fall. Well, the moment he said that, I realized he thought I was applying for New York University, whereas I was looking for advice where to go to high school, which would have been a very different proposition, where of course they would have to take you whenever you show up. I didn't let on. That already showed how shamelessly entrepreneurial I was. And said, gee, that's too bad, but maybe when could I do it the next time or something like that? Because I saw instantaneously that I might gain 2 years. It's not something to be sneezed at. And he said, I'll tell you, I have a friend who teaches at Newark Junior College in Newark, New Jersey, across the river. And maybe they'll accept you for the second semester, which started in January. And he called them right then and there, and he said, they would look at this. Well, he had looked at my grades, which were all A's and so on. And if you think about it, the subjects that were taken at that time in a Central European gymnasium was really much more impressive than an American high school. I remember I had, in other words, just in terms of languages, I had Latin and Bulgarian and German and French, four languages, and then, you know, the math was more advanced than it was in an American high school, etc. And so I went to Newark, New Jersey a few days later across the Hudson, a city which in some respects is the Pits, but it wasn't quite that way, and all one has to do is read Philip Roth, who comes from Newark, New Jersey, a particular Portnoy's Complaint, which is all about a Newark, New Jersey story, and one can see there are interesting flavors about this place. And they accepted me. So lo and behold, I instantaneously gained 2 years.